Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you the basic comparison of TCP and UDP protocol. In my previous video, I have explained you OSI model. In OSI model with layer 4, we have transport layer. Along with transport layer, we access TCP and UDP both of these protocols. So to understand differences in between TCP and UDP protocol, first of all, you need to understand in which situation TCP and UDP protocol both are being used. Let me give you some examples. Like for example, as if you want to access email. Let us say you are having email received in your Gmail ID. So you want to access that email. Let us say inside email, one PDF file is there. Now you want to download that PDF file. Then what you will be doing is you will be clicking on download. So what will happen? You will be requesting server, that server of Gmail is there with Google. So you will be requesting Google to download that file. Now Google will be sending that file to you. But that file comes from USA to you. For example, in USA with that server, that file is there, right? So that file comes from Google server of USA to you. So what if that some of that data is getting lost in between? The reason is, for example, right now I'm staying over here in India. I'm accessing file from USA. So from USA to India, when that file comes, it is possible some of those data may get lost. So in TCP protocol, what happens is, as if some packets are getting lost, then receiver will ask that data to resend it back, right? So again, that data will be forwarded on TCP protocol, so that you can have errorless communication. Even though some errors are there in packets, again you will be receiving it back as per automatic repeat request, right? So error-free connection will be there with TCP. While as if we talk about UDP, then let me give you one more example. Like for example, you are watching live match on browser. Like right now people are watching IPL on browser, right? With Jio Cinema. So when you watch live match at that time, is it like if some data is getting lost, then again there will be resend process? No. As if some data is getting lost, we avoid that. We are focusing on new data, right? So when it comes to live video chat, live conferences, or you can say broadcasting, so in those situations we will be using UDP, where we don't talk about resending of data as if error is there. So UDP will be communicating as per errored communication, in which we are not having resending facility, right? While with TCP, secured connection will be there, in that as if data is having some error, then again automatic repeat request will be given. Based on that, we will be receiving that data again, right? Now let us try to understand these differences along with some parameters, so that will give you more clarity. So TCP is connection oriented communication protocol and UDP is connectionless. See, connection oriented means what? Here we are performing connection, like handshaking is being done. Handshaking means what? Like there is a transmitter and receiver. Now transmitter wants to transmit to receiver. In that case, see, in connection oriented, what we do is transmitter is asking receiver whether I should transmit or not. If receiver is free, then receiver will give acknowledgement. Okay, I'm free right now, you can transmit. Then transmitter will transmit the data. That is what handshaking process, and that is referred as connection oriented process. While in UDP, that asking and all those things, that is not happening. Transmitter is transmitting data irrespective of receiver is receiving or not, right? That is connectionless. Like in Jio Cinema, when you watch live IPL match, at that time that web browser is not bothering about whether you receive that data properly or not. That server will send data continuously irrespective of whether your connection is proper or not, right? So connectionless connection is there with UDP, and with TCP there will be connection oriented process, right? Here TCP connection will be lossless and secure. Why? The reason is, if data is having loss, then again resend process that we do it with TCP, and as if data is having loss, in that case We don't do resend process over here. So UDP is lossy and unsecure, right? Here, when we talk about TCP, in that we perform feedback operation, like transmitter is sending data to receiver. After receiver is receiving that data, receiver will give acknowledgement to transmitter that explains whether received data is proper or not, right? So that is based on feedback. So feedback based system is there with TCP. There is no feedback in UDP. Here, TCP connection is slow and UDP connection is fast. Why? The reason is in TCP, we perform that feedback and all those things, acknowledgement and all those things, right? That's why it is secure, but it is slow. While with UDP, we don't perform that feedback and all those things. That's why it is fast, right? Here, when it comes to error-free connection, then obviously TCP is having error-free connection. While with UDP, errored packets are discarded, right? When it comes to flow control, then TCP will be performing flow control, right? And when it comes to UDP, in that there will be no flow control. So you should know what is the meaning of flow control. Like you see, you are having one transmitter and one receiver. Now transmitter is capable of with handling speed of 10 Mbps, but receiver is having handling capacity of 1 Mbps only. Then what will happen? As if transmitter is sending data with 10 Mbps, but receiver can handle at up to 1 Mbps only, then the receiver cannot take those 10 Mbps speed data, right? So there is a need of flow control, which is happening inside TCP, right? While with UDP, that will not happen. Like for example, as if in Jio Cinema, they are sending data with 4K clarity with 100 Mbps speed. I'm just giving you example. I don't know what by what speed they are sending data, but as if they are sending data with 4K quality, but with you, as if speed is only 1 Mbps, then is it like you will be receiving 4K quality at your home? No, right? Here, what they do is they provide services as per resolution. Like you may be receiving quality of 4K, then full HD 1080 pixel, then 720, then 480 pixel, then 320 pixel, then 144 pixel, right? So based on your bandwidth only, you will be receiving data. Even though transmitter is sending data with 4K quality, you cannot receive that with 4K quality. Why? The reason is you don't have that access speed. So no flow control that is there with UDP. So if I'm having bandwidth of 1 Mbps, then I can take 1 Mbps data only, right? I cannot take data speed with 4K quality. But with YouTube, I can access 4K quality. Why? The reason is it is TCP. In YouTube, I may have to wait till buffer is getting filled, right? But in live broadcast, I cannot take that with 4K quality. So that is how difference is there, right? Now, when it comes to connection, then you should know TCP usually uses point-to-point connection, while UDP supports multicast and broadcast. So I have already given some examples, right? Like multicast and broadcast, that is being supported by UDP, while point-to-point connection, that is there with TCP. Here, when it comes to handshaking operation, so that is happening inside TCP, while there is no handshaking operation with UDP. Handshaking means what? When connection is been established, at that time, there is a process of communication. Like, are you free or not? Then acknowledgement will be given. So that is handshaking. While with UDP, that handshaking is not happening, right? When it comes to overhead, then with TCP, there will be more overhead. Why? The reason is, here we will be forwarding information related source and destination, right? So error-free connection is required, as well as source destination addresses are required. That's why there will be more overhead, typically in between 20 to 60 bytes. While with UDP, less overhead will be there in terms of 8 bytes. So you can say overhead that will be more with TCP and less with UDP. When it comes to protocols, then with TCP, protocols like HTTP, HTTPS, which are the protocol which belongs to web browser, as well as file transfer protocol, SMTP protocol that belongs to email services, those protocols are being used with TCP. While with UDP, DNS, TFTP, SNMP, these protocols that we use, right? I'll be giving brief introduction about all these protocols in great detail. Right now, just consider these are the protocols which are there with TCP and UDP. And when it comes to basic examples, I have already given those examples like web page accessing, email accessing, that happens along with TCP protocol, while video chat, live stream, all those things that is there with UDP protocol, right? So this is how basic comparison is there in between TCP and UDP. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you would like to share it with me, note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.